Hello, Motmos. Ralphie here. Whiskey review 45. And we're going to Japan. Japanese whiskey, very interesting indeed. There we go. One of the best things to do with any whiskey, pour a small glass and taste it. Now, some Scots are a bit parochial and narrow-minded, and they claim that there's only one whiskey in the world, and that's Scotch whiskey. However, you and I are more enlightened, along with the majority of Scots folk, and we know that whiskey comes from many sources: Japan, Ireland, America, Canada, India, all over. And it's always well worth while having the experience. And with this Yuichi, before I kind of give you a bit more details, I'm going to do something interesting here and pour another glass. And this time, it's Springbank, our old friend Springbank. Now, the reason's simple. Yuichi is a small craft distillery that uses direct fired stills. So does Springbank. So to make the comparison between a Japanese whiskey and a Scotch whiskey, this is probably the best one to use. A little bit about the Japanese. Around about 1917-1918, a sake maker called Masataka Taketsuru came to Scotland from Japan and studied whiskey making at Glasgow University. With the skills that he learned, along with his considerable enthusiasm, he went back to Japan, to the North Island of Hokkaido, and built a small distillery called Yuichi. Fascinating little place, I'd love to visit. Japan as a whole is a very interesting country to go to. And the distillery was very much following craft tradition, direct fired stills and all the rest of it. And it's got to the stage now, at the end of the 20th century into the 21st century, where Japanese whiskey is winning prizes at international awards for its quality. Now, the reason Japanese whiskey is winning prizes is because of wood, quality of wood, whereas the Japanese took time to invest a lot of money in the quality of wood for the whiskey. There has been a tendency in the Scotch whiskey industry, more of a cost-cutting exercise, particularly in the 1980s. However, it's good to see that things have kind of rectified, and it's because Japanese whiskey is coming onto the market and is circulating around that the people that make the decisions in the Scotch whisky industry say, hang about, we've been resting on our laurels. Let's try a bit harder. Good. So, when you first look at Japanese whisky, you think to yourself, oh, these Japanese, they know how to copy. But when you put a Japanese and Scotch whisky side by side, you start to notice differences. Subtle, slight differences, but they all add up. Japanese whisky is very much manufactured by design and by method. Scotch whisky is more by default. It's just the provenance. It's just the luck. It just happens that Scotland's a very lucky place to make whisky. Japanese whisky is rather like French cuisine. What you get on the plate, in the glass, is the skill of the chef. and the way they use the ingredients. Whereas with Scotch whisky, what you're getting is not so much the skill of the chef, but the chef who understands the intrinsic quality of the natural ingredients and allows them to express themselves. The Japanese have a phrase, it's called wabi-sabi, and basically translated, things get lost in translation, but basically translated, it means perfection identified by flaw. And nature, Mother Nature, does this perfectly. And there's nothing finer. If you want to see wabi-sabi in Scotland, just look at a dry stone wall with moss and lichen on it. That is perfect wabi-sabi. Japanese strive for this in whisky, and with age, with the influence, increasing influence of good wood, it is appearing. But in the younger whiskies, you do notice that there's an awful lot going on, balanced out, without a particular character. It's very good, very accomplished. My notes for the Yoichi are medium malt, balanced, deep, quite deep in the nose, sweet and sherried. Don't really add more than a smidgen of water. It drowns very quickly, rather like a blend. It's almost like a single malt that behaves like a Scotch blended whisky. Taste wise, integrated flavours, rich, vague, malty, some spice, zips around and fades away fast. With a Scotch whisky, there's more daring, there's more risk taking, there's more nature taking its course. Again, in presenting this, I have to generalise a little, but it's really to let you get a better handle on the difference between Japanese and Scotch whisky. Japanese whisky would improve if the Japanese would allow it to be more Japanese and less Scotch. So there we have it. Anyway, marks, and a special commendation, by the way, for Japanese whisky packaging. Look, nice, neat cardboard box. No need for metals and wasteful materials. Very nice indeed. 86 out of 100, and well earned. Other Japanese whiskies to look out for are, here's my wee list, Hokusho, that's a good one, Yamazaki, and Satsuma, if you can find that one, that's a lesser known Japanese whisky. So there we have it, Ralphie.com. Hope you've enjoyed this little introduction to Japanese single malts. Yoichi is the one I would go for, and happy dramming. See you soon.